Welcome to Morgan and Friends on Tuesday, April 7th. How are you hanging in there? What's that? Oh, I know, me too. Going a little stir crazy, aren't ya? Well, unfortunately, but fortunately, our governor, Mr. Polis, did extend the stay-at-home order for now. So I thought it might be interesting and fun to get kind of creative and create our own masks to encourage everyone to participate in the Colorado Mask Project. Let's check it out. Okay, we're back with some of our materials. All we're gonna need is an old t-shirt, and I'm gonna make one with Harlow for her face. So I picked one of her old t-shirts that she's grown out of and some scissors, okay? And what we're gonna do is we're gonna lay it on the ground like so.
Go.
Okay, so we've got that shirt. We've got their scissors ready. We're gonna put our hands here to measure the width of what we're gonna cut. And then we're gonna cut about there. You can eyeball it from there. And you're gonna just cut, 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 cut. Keep on cutting until you got it done. Okay, now you've got that. And then you're gonna do one more cut down the middle of the top piece of fabric so you can open it up in a line like that. From there, now this is the tricky part because you've got to be careful not to cut all of it. You're going to fold it in half. Fold that strip right in half, end to end. Make sure you do that. Okay. And then I'm going to take the scissors again and I'm going to cut the open end. And I'm going to cut the open end. To about there. So I've still got about a couple inches left. Then I'm gonna do the same to the other side, like so. And then I've got the finished product. Okay, so once you have that finished product, you're actually gonna do one last step, so it's not quite finished yet, I guess. You're gonna cut here. You're gonna cut this off. Make sure you don't cut the strap off that you just cut. And then you're gonna do that same thing over here. And then your finished product is going to look like that, okay?
Hi guys, so I'm going to show you how to tie it. So first, you put your mask like this. Then you put this, the first one, behind your ears. And you tie it. And then with the next one, you're gonna put it a little bit higher. And then you're gonna tie it up there too. And that's how you make your mask, and by not spreading it to others. I hope you enjoyed the lesson today. Bye.
So did you make your mask yet? I sure hope so. There's lots of different things that we can do for masks, but it's important that every time we go out in public, we wear that mask, okay? So that we can go back to seeing our friends and going to school and all those fun activities. In the meantime, let's go visit someone special. Who could that be? Is it Miss Trish again? Let's check it out.
Today's lesson, starting seeds for your garden.
First,
First, you'll need some clear cups or glass jars. Next, you'll need about a cup full of these small pebbles to use for drainage.
Inch by inch, row by row,
evenly distribute the small pebbles into the bottom of each cup.
All it takes is a rake and a hoe.
You'll also need soil. I use equal parts potting soil and compost.
Row by row, someone bless these seeds I sow.
Fill the cups with the soil mixture about 3/4 of the way full. Next, you'll need to choose which seeds you'd like to plant.
Pulling weeds and picking
stones. I have sugar snap peas,
man is made of
garden beans,
peas,
and pumpkin seeds. Next, you'll need to use a spray bottle to moisten the soil before you put in the seeds.
My way in nature's chain, to my body,
then add your seeds
to the music from the land,
and cover with a thin layer of soil on the top of the seeds. Moisten the soil again, then label your cup.
Plant your rows straight and long, temper them with prayer and song. Mother Earth will make you
set
strong.
Set your cups in a sunny windowsill and give them water every day.
Old crow watching hungrily.
I'll keep you updated on how my seedlings are growing. Happy gardening!
In my garden.
2, 1, go!
Kids' guitar here. Anyway, thanks, Miss Trish. It's always so much fun hanging out with you. I hope you guys get to plant some seeds while we're home.
Mama.
Now, let's go check out some songs that we can sing with that guitar. Miss Britt, thanks for sharing.
Hi, friends. I have 4 more songs to sing with you today. And the first one and the last one are going to have sign language. And the first one will be, "You Are My Sunshine." You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. And now we're going to sing the Itsy Bitsy Spider. Oh, the itsy bitsy spider crawled up the water spout. Down came the rain and washed the spider out. Out came the sun and dried up all the rain. And the itsy bitsy spider crawled up the spout again. And now we're gonna sing 3 Little Ducks. 3 little ducks went out one day, over the hill and far away. Mother duck said quack, 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 quack. And 2 little ducks came waddling back. 2 little ducks went out one day, over the hill and far away. Mother duck said quack, 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 quack. And 1 little duck came waddling back. 1 little duck went out one day, over the hill and far away. Mother duck said quack, 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 quack. And no little ducks came waddling back. Sad mother duck went out one day, over the hill and far away. Mother duck said quack, 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 quack. And all 3 ducks came waddling back. And now we're going to sing, "Row, row, row your boat." Row, row, row your boat, gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream. Row, row, row your boat, gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream.
You guys, did you learn some new songs or sing along? I hope so. I love singing. Just kidding, but I do love singing. Now, let's see. What else can we do today? Oh, I know. I have a special guest here. She's 7. And she is going to read for us all the way from her house. I hope you enjoy her book. And let's welcome Miss Eliza Shackelford.
Hi, friends. This is Greta. And I have Eliza Shackelford here who is going to read Bear on a Bike for you guys today. I miss you. Hope to see you soon.
Bear on a bike. Bear on a bike. Bear on a bike, as happy as can be. Where are you going? Bear, please wait for me. I'm going to the market where fruit and flowers are sold, where people buy fresh oranges and pots of marigolds. Bear on a raft, as happy as can be. Where are you going, Bear? Please wait for me. I'm going to the forest where fearsome creatures prowl, where raccoons play and bobcats snarl, and hungry foxes howl. Bear in a steam train, as happy as can be. Where are you going, Bear? Please wait for me. I'm going to the seaside where children love to play, where young friends dig and race and swim while fishes dart away. Bear on a boat, as happy as can be. Where are you going, Bear? Please wait for me. I'm going to an island where magic star fruits grow, where herons fish, and secret groves and sparkling rivers flow. Bear in a carriage, as happy as can be. Where are you going, Bear? Please wait for me. I'm going to a castle where night is turned to day, where princes and princesses dance and merry music plays. Bear in a rocket flying through the night, wherever you are going, Bear, goodbye and good night. The end.
Eliza! Thank you so much, sweetheart. You're such a wonderful reader and such a great friend. I hope you all at home enjoyed that so much. And let's go back to getting rid of germs. After all, we are trying to get rid of this virus, aren't we? Miss Gwen, she's going to teach us a little something about washing our hands properly. So let's go check out her lesson with her son, Emerson.
I'm going to wear ready. Get out of here, COVID.
Hey guys, today we're going to demonstrate how we do some hand washing today. So I was singing Happy Birthday twice. There's a little song that we sing at school. So Emerson's going to be my assistant with this. So Emerson, we're going to turn on water, right? Get your hands wet. Okay, let's do a pump of soap, please. One pump for mommy. Ready to sing our song?
Yeah.
Top and bottom, top and bottom, in between. Rub your hands together, rub your hands together. Now they're clean, now they're clean. now we rinse off the soap. Can we rinse the soap?
Yeah.
And then can we grab a towel?
Yeah.
Step down. Grab the towel. And then we come and turn off the water.
She's gonna run and run and run and run.
So that's a little song that we sing at school to wash your hands. Hope you guys enjoy the video.
Bye, guys. I miss you. Wash your hands.
Oh. Hi, everyone. Sorry, I was just practicing washing my hands. Whew. Well, now that I've got my hands washed, let's go check out our last segment of the day. We've got Miss Ashley from our Brown Bear room, and she's gonna read aloud. Come on, friends, let's check it out, and we'll talk to you tomorrow, okay? Goodbye.
Hi, Little Red friends, it's Miss Ashley, and I'm here today to read you guys a story. I'm gonna read If You Take a Mouse to School, because we're all missing school so much right now. If you take a mouse to school, he'll ask you for your lunchbox. When you give him your lunchbox, he'll want a sandwich and a snack for later. He'll need a notebook and some pencils. He'll probably want to share your backpack too. When you get to school, he'll put his things in your locker and take a look around. He might do a little math and spell a word or two. He'll even try a science experiment. Then he'll need to wash up. You'll have to take him to the bathroom. Once he's nice and clean, he'll be ready for his lunch. On the way to the lunchroom, he'll see some building blocks. He'll build a little mouse house and make some furniture out of clay. He'll need some books for his bookshelf, and he'll start by writing one of his own. So he'll need a lot of paper. He'll probably use up all your pencils, and when he's finished, he'll want to read his book to you. He'll want to take it home, so he'll put it in your lunchbox and tuck it in a safe place. And when the bell rings, he'll run out to wait for the bus. While he's waiting, he'll play a quick game of soccer, and he'll ask you to shoot a few baskets and do a little skateboarding. He'll stop to catch his breath, and he'll want to eat a snack. So he'll ask you for your lunchbox, and chances are, if he asks you for your lunchbox, you'll have to take him back to school. The end.